Hey, Jim. I heard that you and Jimmy are insulating and bricking a Corsair Arch today. Do you think you could give us an overview of what you're doing?
You bet. We have our open house coming up where we're going to be doing a live demonstration, and we are going to be insulating and fire bricking a 2-foot by 4-foot Corsair for a hybrid pan. And I think that's a good idea. We do make it as easy as possible for the end user. We send pre-cut fire brick with every Corsair, and we have very nice instructions for them, but a video is worth 1,000 words, and I think this is a good opportunity to finally make a video that shows exactly how we do it. Now, the Corsair is available in a multitude of sizes, widths and lengths, and it also has many different pan configurations. So I will at least mention where you might have a unique step for that pan, for a given pan configuration as we go. But again, we're setting it up for a hybrid pan. And yeah, I say we get to it. I think this would be a great thing for everybody. We're gonna do like a general overview of insulating and bricking a Corsair today. What we happen to be doing is a 2-foot by 4-foot Corsair that we're setting up for our open house boil. There's a little bit more insulation that's going to go in at the very end when we're done fire bricking, but before we start fire bricking, it's as insulated as it's going to be. So you see, if I take these brick shelves out, this piece of insulation, this is one piece that goes from here to the front. It goes down to where the brick shelves are. That's a 24-inch width of the roll of insulation that comes with your arch. It's cut to the profile of the firebox. None of this is glued. And then this piece here spans between the floor and the bottom of this piece of insulation.
But not required?
That one I like to do because it doesn't take a lot of insulation, and it really eliminates the possibility that the sides of your arch could ever get much heat exposed to them. Technically, you're right. There's no heat under there. That's all cold air in that area, but I just think that for the little bit of effort it takes, it's worth doing.
Okay.
Then there's another piece of insulation back here. This insulation is a one-piece covering that goes from here down, forward, down, all the way to the base where the fire brick starts. We do have a couple pieces of insulation here. We have one piece of insulation on this back, on the very back of the arch, before we put our final piece in. Also, we're running a hybrid drop flue evaporator, so we had room for one extra layer of insulation here. So there's one extra layer under this belly piece.
Again, just a note, we're going to be using this arch with a hybrid pan, so we have enough space to add this extra layer of insulation, which will help push the heat up into the flues. If you have a high output drop flue pan set, do not add any extra insulation. Your flues are deeper and require more space.
If you have a raised flue evaporator or a flat pan evaporator, you will actually get a sheet metal riser where after you put your side insulation in, you will put it's just a sheet metal frame that you put down right here. The front of it is even with this apex of the sheet metal of the arch. Then this piece of insulation rides up over the top of that belly riser and down. So that's a good point, that in a drop flue evaporator, that's the only time you won't have a belly riser of some kind. Or if you have a 2-foot by 3-foot Corsair, which is really unusual, that doesn't have a belly riser even of any kind ever used. But 2x4 and up, if you have a raised flue pan or a flat pan, there will be a belly riser included with your arch. All of this insulation comes in the Corsair. The door and the front, that's fully insulated when it gets to your place, so that's not something you have to worry about. We also do, on ours, have insulation on the floor. You see that under there? We have some cardboard in there because we want to protect that a little bit from mortar spilling on it. The reason we do that is because we have an epoxy floor in our showroom,
And we're just trying to keep any heat, as much heat as we can off of that epoxy floor. So that's not normally necessary to have that insulation there, but it's something we do when we're running in our showroom. So that's a kind of a special thing for us, I guess, but it doesn't hurt to do it.
We're getting to the last phase or the last couple pieces here of setting up this Corsair arch with all the insulation and bricks. We got our dome grate set. We have our bricks laid in. We have a couple final pieces of insulation to put in. And these are the insulating strips that go along between the top of the brick and the top of the top rail of the arch. It's really, really important that we protect this rail. This rail under here should be protected from heat. If that gets hit with heat, it's gonna wanna expand and move, and that's what metal does. And that's normal for metal to do that. So what we're gonna do is lay another strip of insulation approximately 30 inches along the top of the brick here, and then tuck that in. So I have some of these preset and cut. And usually, it may vary a little bit how high we would put these, because your bricks might lay just a little different, but usually it's between 4.5 to 5 inches that this strip is, by about 30 inches, sometimes a little less. So we're gonna tuck that insulation strip in right here. And then what we're doing here is it tucks in nicely and it's creating it flush so that my top rail of insulation is sitting in here really nice, and now it's flush to the top rail. You can kind of see how that sits in nicely. And so we're gonna do that with all four strips of insulation that sit in here. And the same thing here. We're gonna tuck this in, and I got a little bit thicker piece for the back. That back piece is gonna be an inch or two longer, but a similar length of about just under 30 inches, but each build may vary a little bit based on what you tuck the rest of your insulation in at. So now we have a really nice, snug, tight fit here under this top rail to really protect that insulation. This stuff is easy to work with. A lot of times what I tend to do is I make the area that I'm tucking it, the insulation, just a little bigger than the spot I want to tuck it into. And that is going to be just fine. Now the last little tweak that I have, that's a little bonus if you happen to have just a little bit of insulation left and you're running a forced draft evaporator. The forced draft evaporator comes with the specialized dome grates and the blower. And so it's pushing a lot of air under the grates. And every now and then, let's take a look at the draft door.
So this is for natural draft, this door?
Yep, so the door, yep, exactly. The door here is open when we're running natural draft. So that's why you have a door on your Corsair if you ever wanted to run natural draft. But some of you are running forced draft, and you might wanna with forced draft, you might see just like a little bit of sometimes ash fly out the bottom of the door, just a tiny bit. And so if that's something that's a concern, one little tweak you can do is take another strip of insulation like this. This one is about 4 by about 15.5 inches. And I'm gonna just tuck it inside the open face. If we're feeding the fire with forced air, we don't need that in there. And I would just kind of, again, I make this a little bigger and you can gently just place it in there and tuck that in. Now that creates a really nice seal underneath there that is gonna just kind of seal off and not allow any more heat to come out. And then we can shut that, and then that creates a nice, and you can even go from the inside with your grates out and just kind of press that once the door is shut. And that will work really nice to kind of seal off for a little bit of added benefit there.
Smoky Lake includes a 15-foot roll of insulation with every 2x4 Corsair evaporator. All of these essential pieces can be cut from that provided roll. When you're insulating, you will start with three strips
approximately 24 by 9 inches. Next, the sides of the firebox. Then the belly. Remember, if you have a flat pan or a raised flue pan, the insulation rides over the top of the belly riser. As Jimmy showed us earlier, after you've bricked the firebox, we need to protect the top rail of the arch with a second layer of insulation. If you do need a bit more insulation for your project, you can find rolls of insulation on smokylakemaple.com with free shipping in the continental US. Join us again next week for the next video in this series, and we show you how to brick this Corsair. This is what it boils down to.
All right.